Asian markets ended Thursday trade with solid gains, with investors cheering increased bets of a September rate cut from the Fed. Japan's Nikkei 225 saw a new record close as it breached the 42,000 level. The biggest gainer, though, was the Hong Kong Hang Seng Index, which jumped 2%. The local bourse also joining the rally, with the main index closing above 66,000 for the first time in 1.5 months.
The expectations for the earnings are pretty good, and we might see a little bit of exceeding when it comes to utilities. I think electricity distribution looks pretty good given how hot summer has been. Yeah. Water as well are both connected to that. Property as well as the banking sector, we think will continue to either outperform, or because of the first quarter results, we are already seeing that certain analysts are increasing their target. Aside from the earnings report, there is going to be a State of the Nation address upcoming, and we also will be monitoring the Philippine peso, which from what we know has, the Banco Central has done a little bit of, small amounts of intervention here.
A notable stock movement in the region, shares of Uniqlo owner Fast Retailing closed 2% higher. That's after it raised its full-year profit forecast to $2.94 billion for what would be its third consecutive year of record-high profits. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. appoints veteran banker Walter Wasmer to the Central Bank's Monetary Board. Wasmer has been a consultant and non-executive director for BDO Unibank since 2022. He also served as BDO's senior executive vice president and institutional banking group head from 1997 to 2022. Wasmer will be the fifth member of the Monetary Board. He fills one of the vacant seats on the seven-member board after Bruce Tolentino and Anita Linda Aquino resigned last month. The Philippine Investment Board approves 950 billion pesos worth of investments in the first half of the year. That's a 36% increase compared to the same period last year. 30% of the BOI approved investments for 2024 composed of foreign investments amounting to over 280 billion pesos. This comes on the heels of the central bank reporting a 37% drop in net foreign direct investment inflows for April. The country's trade chief sees this as a temporary setback influenced by global economic headwinds. Secretary Alfredo Pascual maintains the increase in FDI over the first 4 months, and the investment pipeline from the BOI will continue to boost confidence in the Philippine economy. A major milestone for the U.S. government. The U.S. Treasury Department and the Internal Revenue Service announced they have collected more than $1 billion in past due tax debt from millionaires over the past year. In September last year, the IRS launched an initiative to pursue individuals with more than $1 million in income who have failed to pay tax debt. The agency say if efforts are sustained, the initiative could generate up to $851 billion in additional revenue through the year 2034.